Welcome to the Daily Mat. Today's episode is sponsored in part by Highland Woodworking. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. Visit their website at leevalley.com.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Daily Mat. This is our first episode of 2000. And what I've got planned for the next several Daily Mats is I want to start answering some of your questions. We had some really fantastic questions came in just before the holiday break and, of course, over the holiday break. And so, of course, what we need to do is to start answering those. And I thought what we would do is we begin 2010 off talking about hand planes, because this is a question a lot of you have. And as you know, I prefer to use hand tools of all sorts whenever I'm working on my projects, whether it's hand planes, hand saws, chisels, using like say a router plane instead of a router, which we're gonna have to talk a little bit about that. It's not a router in the sense of what you think as a powered router. It's something completely different, but there are hand tools that you could use to get a profile much like you would a powered router. So of course we're getting a little bit ahead of ourselves, which is very common around here, and we'll be talking about that much further down the road. So what we're going to do this week is these couple of episodes, let's talk about the bench planes, because this is one of those, it can be very, very confusing, and it has everything to do with the numbering system. So first of all, let's find out what are bench planes, what are specialty planes, and then let's go from there. Okay, so this is a lineup of our basic bench planes. Now we start over here on the end with our jointers, go to the middle, which would be like our jack planes. We have our smoothers, our block planes, and then our scrub plane. Now let's talk a little bit about each one. Okay, so now that we know which ones are the bench planes, let's talk about how we use them. Now when it comes to using the bench planes, there's a great article that my guru Chris Schwartz had written quite a long time ago, and I follow it pretty much with everything that I do, and not just with the bench planes, but with all of my tools. And it's the idea of coarse, medium, and fine. Now he has the, like I said, he has the magazine article, and he also has a DVD by the same title, which is available through Lee Nielsen, called Coarse, Medium, and Fine. And the idea, the whole concept, is that you have tools that do coarse work. In other words, you take the raw material and you're going to shape it into the basic dimensions that you need. You're going to take it from its really, really rough stage down to a more manageable stage. And then you have a medium set of tools which further refine that coarse work that you just did. It gets it almost exactly where you want it. But yeah, it's still a little rough. Maybe it has just some slight tool marks on it. Maybe the dimensions are just a pinch off, because you want to come in and finish it up a little bit. And then you have the fine tools that do very, very minimal work, but the minimal work that they do makes a huge difference between that medium stage and the finish stage. Very much like sandpaper. You have coarse sandpaper, like at an 80 grit, you have medium sandpaper, let's say like a 150 to 180, and then you have fine sandpaper, like 220 on up to like 600. So that's how we're gonna do our work. And the way that we have the bench planes laid out right now is actually misleading, because you wouldn't start at one end and work to the other. It's very much like the numbering system with hand planes, extremely misleading. If you think of the idea that you would start with a number one and work your way up to like a number eight, you're actually kind of working backwards. And in fact, you're kind of jumbling things up, but I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself here. So when it comes to the numbering system, we're gonna kind of just throw that out there and we'll just refer to them by the numbers, but we're not gonna use them by the numbers. So let's do this first. For today's episode, let's arrange the bench planes in the order that we would actually use them, in the sense of coarse, medium, and fine. So let's go ahead and get started with our coarse tools. And these are the ones, like I said, we're gonna take our rough material and we're gonna give it its basic shape. And there's really only two hand planes that we're gonna do this with. Number one, and again, this first one I'm going to mention technically is more of a specialized tool, at least in some people's opinion. In mine, I go back and forth depending on whether I need it or not, because I don't always grab it when I'm doing the coursework. But when I do grab it, I'm really glad it's there. And that's my scrub plane. This is a very, very coarse tool. In fact, I'm not even going to try and get the chip breaker out. But if you were to see the blade itself, and I'll try to put a splash up of a photo on it, the blade has a very spoon-like. It's very, very rounded. And the idea is that it's going to get right in there and just take out large chunks of wood to remove a lot of material. Now, when it's sharp, those chunks aren't going to tear out on you so much. But you're still going to remove some really, really thick pieces. And that's where the scrub plane comes in. Now, along with the scrub plane, our other coarse tool that we're going to use is the jack plane. And, you know, one thing, I've always referred to the jack plane, I said, oh, it's from the idea that it's like, you know, the most common one. You know, it's a jack of all trades. But, in fact, after watching several pirate movies and, sailing movie, Commander Farside of the World, jack is a common term for just common. That's what jack means. So it's a very common plane, one that you would grab for. It can do coarse work. You can even set it up for medium work, and you can even set it up for fine work. So very, very common plane. In fact, it makes sense that you would call it a common plane also in the sense that if you go on eBay, there's thousands of these out there. So you should pick up a rather inexpensive one or pick up a new one. These are really great ones, and like I said, you'll use them all the time. And I use this in my coursework. If I've used the scrub plane, I'll tend to come in with my jack plane, and the idea with this is that I can get in there and I can really knock down any hills and everything. And we'll talk a little bit more about knocking down those hills. But I would tend to, this would either be my first or second hand plane that I would grab, again, depending on whether I use the scrub plane. And I use this before I grab my jointing planes. Now, it's kind of counterintuitive because you think, well, you always talk about with the jointer plane, the idea is that you're knocking down the hills. Doesn't it seem like this one could get caught in there? But like I said, this is coarse work. We're gonna just rough the surface up, or we're gonna smooth the rough surface, and we're gonna make it ready for our other tools. So this is number one or number two. And these two belong together. These are our coarse tools, the scrub and the jack plane.
Thanks for watching. For more information on today's episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. And a huge thanks to our sponsors, Highland Woodworking and Lee Valley. Visit them today.